Hello and welcome back to Elizabeth's boobs. I mean, Elizabeth talking to us.
Oh my god, she's wanting us to touch them. Wait, why are we choking? We haven't even gotten the fucking. Why are you choking before fucking? Okay, gotcha. Understand. So, Andy pointed out, the reason why I want you to put hashtag VigorT in the comments down below at the episodes, do it now, is because the powers in BioShock Infinite are called Vigors, and our logo is a teacup with game controls on it. So,
so for the future, Brayden wants to put something related to the game we're playing, Vigor, and then T after it.
Yeah, so this game is Vigor T. So I've already thought it through if we played the other BioShock games. This one's Vigor T.
Plasma T.
Plasma T will be number one, and then BioShock 2 is going to be Big Daddy T.
And BioShock 2 is not going to happen because that game's terrible.
So Big Daddy T won't be a thing. I do like the idea of Big Daddy T, though. It just sounds funny. Look at how calmly she's just staring, like, ah, yes, the world's going to shit.
Or you can call it Little Girl T.
Ooh, no. LGT.
Almost LGBT, but not quite.
So close. One letter off. We're trying to, and then like Onigiri will be like hashtag Kawaii T.
Kawaii T. Damn it, so any other anime related game we play can't have it.
Oh shit, maybe we should do something else. Hashtag MMOT. Whee. Hashtag,
I know there's enemies, but I don't see a single one.
Penis T.
Penis T.
Penis bum.
That salts.
The world is going to shit.
Watch your fuck door.
Oh, so you've played this before. How far are we into the game by this point?
Oh,
see, sweet.
You say that as though I've played this game
oh.
a lot.
Oh, did you see him? He, like, melted.
Yep.
In, like, a pool of bloody nastiness.
I think we're definitely getting closer to the end. We still got a little bit of game left.
Okay. Because it almost seems like we're, like, really close.
We're getting there.
Especially because
I think we've only got one more vigor to get.
Yeah. Yeah, we only have, by the looks of just how big the slots are, we only have one more vigor left.
Let me up there. Let me up there.
No. Wee.
Hi-ya!
Oh.
Fuck you. Fuck you. And fuck yourself.
Oh, look at all the blood on the screen. Oh, so that reminds me, for anyone who is actually watching this, if you have any suggestions for games that you would like to see played in the future,
I would love for people to give me recommendations on that.
Yeah, I'd leave that with your VigorT comment. Or do see two separate comments, that works too. Or like five, I don't know, I don't care.
Just fucking flooding, I don't give a shit.
I don't give a shit, I'll answer back every single one.
You'll be like the only person to go for it.
Yeah.
Who cares?
Yeah, rack up that view. Rack up that views, I'd like five. Whee! Oh,
that
shit.
That almost hit me.
That almost killed you.
I don't think it would have actually affected me at all. It probably would have just, like, glitched right through me.
Would have been funny if it knocked you right off the skyline. You died.
The handyman can temporarily electrify skylines, damaging anyone riding them. Stay off the skylines until the electricity stops.
Oh, well, that explains what happened last time.
Fuck you, man. I'll electrify you, you wish.
Oh, my face. Oh, my face.
Yeah.
Oh.
Don't cover your chest, it's your weak point. Stop it. Did he just rip his arm off or that arm?
I think so. Also, Handman, you're lame. You're not nearly as cool as Big Daddy's.
No, he's not. Not even slightly.
Not even close.
Bonk.
Beep. Oh, and he's on fire. And he's on electric.
That nose ring right out of you.
Let me think about how I'm going to say this before I mess up more.
He's gone
over his daily limit of electrolytes.
There's a limit?
Yeah. I'd imagine so. There's a limit for everything.
This is true.
Oh, that looks so painful.
So satisfying, though.
Wee.
Is anyone else that wants to die?
No. There probably are more. They're probably just hiding. Not wanting to deal with the
shit. Oh, I hear shooting. Slow down.
So,
where the hell is that coming from?
I don't know. Oh, hello.
Fuck you, man.
Is that it?
Maybe.
Sounds like it was it. Because the music's...
Music's calming down.
Yeah. I love how you just land now and there's just a huge explosion of fire.
What the fuck would the decoy be appointed? It doesn't even look like Booker. Oh, actually, yeah, kind of. It's like a really shitty fucking
version
of Booker.
Yeah. I'd probably see the eyes and go, ah, yes, that is not Booker.
Oh, there are no eyes. That, okay.
Okay.
To Comstock House.
Come on,
to
Elizabeth, let's go.
To Comstock House.
To Comstock House. To the Comstock House. I can't speak English today.
Yeah, that one sip of that awful, awful.
Just fucked up my entire
fuck
day.
Fuck up your entire.
Yeah, I'm not even joking. All that shit's gotta go. Like, it's too gross. I can't do
give
it.
Give one to Steph. See if she likes it. Is it carbonated?
Hold up.
Oh, the lemonade one is shit, too?
Yeah. Oh! Here you go.
No, I don't want it. I don't even like normal lemonade.
Okay, yeah. No, it's carbonated and it's gross.
Gross.
So, I gotta go find a homeless guy. Maybe we should go find the homeless guy who, like, digs through the garbage near my house.
Oh, he's the last one.
Oh! It's a gladiator power. I bet it's
you
lame.
Are Spartacus.
I bet it's lame. Okay. Maybe it just increases your defense. Okay. Oh, yeah.
Return to sender.
Oh, this is your, like, telepathy power.
Boop. I do like that.
That's pretty good, actually. Okay.
I don't really like the whole trap thing.
No, neither do I.
This game is so fast-paced that you don't really need traps.
And plus, from what I remember people saying, the only one... Your game is full.
Oh, she's putting out the lockpick behind it. Thank you.
Oh, nice. Thanks. From what I remember people saying, anyways, the only actual useful trap is Bucking Bronco.
Because it shoots people straight up.
Yeah. And then you just go to town, and then apparently on their way down, you can hit Bucking Bronco again, so they fly instantly right back up. Yeah. So then you can just cheat your way. Sniper, get down! I guess she sounded super serious there for a moment. Oh, seriously, that just like ruined my day.
What?
Those fucking...
Oh, those alcohols?
God, seriously, that's gross.
Fuck.
Oh, nice shot. I'm just so mad.
Ow.
Like, you know how sometimes there are just things that you have and you just have them
yeah.
and then you realize that... It was a horrible decision.
Yes. Peroni?
Yeah, Peroni was...
Those chocolate beers?
Which ones?
All of them.
No, most of them have been okay, but that one that dude recommended to you was not good.
No.
Oh, this is our best chocolate beer we have in store.
Or like if you accidentally cook your steak too much.
Oh, that's the worst,
that's
too.
That's such a disappointment.
Especially because, I don't know, you're a medium rare guy, right?
Or I'm medium.
You're medium?
No, medium rare, actually, yeah.
Yeah, okay, yeah. See, I'm a rare guy when it comes to my steak. So, I can handle medium rare, and that's fine, but as soon as it goes to medium, I just...
No, if it's medium, it's ruined.
I'm just like, aww. And I know people who, like, eat their steaks well done.
And those are people that don't enjoy life.
I know, like, those are literally people who want to, like, ruin their teeth before they're 20.
Ow.
And these people are over 20, so that means they have dentures. I'm pretty sure they have dentures.
Yeah, like, I went to a party at a yacht club while I was in Kelowna the last time I was visiting.
Yeah.
And it was like everyone got a ticket for a steak dinner.
Oh, that's
I was like, sweet.
Sweet.
The steak was so well done.
Oh.
It was fucking disappointing. It was so awful.
That's the worst.
And then, like, everyone was asking me, like, can I get my steak well done? And he's like, oh, these are the well done ones. And he's like, I was like, can I get one medium rare? And he's like, oh, these ones are the more medium rare one. There was no pink in it. None.
That's the worst. That's why I think restaurants who do, like, big, like, group dinners like that or buffet styles like that or anything like that, don't do fucking steaks.
No.
People are just too picky about the preferences that it's just wasting your time trying.
Like, it makes sense why they'd be picky about preferences. Steak is really good one way and then not very good the other
exactly.
way.
Exactly. That's why, like, honestly, the safest choice for restaurants
fish.
And what... Not even fish. The safest choice for most people and the reason why most places will do it is prime rib. Because prime rib, you only eat it one way. You only ever eat it one way.
I've never been a big fan of ribs. I just feel
no,
like...
No, prime rib is not ribs.
Oh.
Here, I'll show you. I'm going to pull up a picture for...
I don't cook, so. Well, if I do, it's pretty much just like steak.
It's your steak and eggs.
Yeah. Which I haven't done in a while.
I'd imagine. Let's see. Yeah.
Well, the last lockpick door I got.
That's probably.
Oh, yeah.
There's no bone under it. It's just a roast, basically. This is another way you can say it. But yeah, that's the safe bet, and that's what most places that do, like, buffet style will do.
Or do, like, chicken wings.
Yeah. But yeah, like, if you're gonna do beef, you do prime rib. Because beef is just too particular. You know what's also strange? That in the States, increase clip size for all weapons by 50%. It's a new shirt.
Oh, so it's just a shittier version of the one I already have.
Wow. Yeah, fuck that. Let's put it on!
I want to give myself a handicap.
Yay! Oh shit, what was I talking about?
Talking about beef.
I know we're talking about beef. Oh yeah, it's just too particular. And then in the States, like, because Canada, you have to have your burgers, like, well done. Like, your burgers have to be cooked that way. But in the States, you can have them rare.
I don't know how that would work for me. Like,
I know, that's what I'm curious about.
So I wouldn't want blood all over my fucking...
Yeah.
Everything else that I have in my burger, right?
Exactly.
Because that's the main reason why I don't like rare, is because I don't like biting into a big vat of blood.
See, no, yeah, see, like, I'm fine with rare, but the people who eat their steaks blue rare, that grosses me out.
Yeah, that's... If there's too much blood, I'm grossed out.
Yeah.
And I'm not even the type of guy that gets grossed out by blood, but having it in my mouth...
Yeah.
It's not my blood, either.
Yeah.
If it's my blood, I'm like, whatever, it's my blood. I got fucking, like, hit in the face or something, and I'm bleeding in my mouth.
Whatever, I'm just sucking on, like, 500 pennies. Like, no worries.
You have a lot of iron in your diet, apparently.
Yeah. It's like, Now, I remember when you... Yeah, we don't have pennies anymore, but I remember when you were, like, little kids, and then you just, like, lick a penny and be like, ew.
I can't honestly say I've ever licked a penny.
I did.
And that's mainly because I'm a germaphobe, and I know that like 100 other people have touched that penny.
You're true. I did lick a penny, and then the first time that I ever, like, tasted my own blood in my mouth, I was like, do I have a penny in my mouth?
Oh, that's disgusting.
Nope. Yeah, so if you've ever tasted your own blood, that's what a penny tastes like. So, yeah!
Unless you have, like, an iron
deficiency, then probably... Cool That'd be sweet. Can we, like, screenshot it, and then I'm gonna use my non-existent money to hire a painter to...
My non-existent money? To paint Elizabeth it. Just running around.
Sweet. And I'm gonna paint it on that wall. Yeah. Why? I don't know. America.
Why? Because you're the biggest BioShock Infinite fan.
I am a massive BioShock Infinite fan. I am such a big fan, I've never played the game until this point.
You're still not playing it, you're just watching me play it.
I'm watching you play it.
You die already, please? Fuck. Thank you.
Oh, there you go. I don't know. I do have to say, though, and I don't know if you've seen the trailer for it, I actually think Battlefield 1 looks really good.
I did see a trailer for it. It's like going back to super old school.
So. World War 1, yeah. I just like that the fact that they're like, yes, Call of Duty is going into, like, space. Let's go backwards.
Call of Duty's going into, like, space.
Let's do what Call of Duty is not doing. Go backwards.
I wouldn't be surprised if the next Call of Duty takes place in space.
This one is.
Is it actually?
I think it's called Call of Duty Future Warfare or something like that.
I know there's Advanced Warfare.
Yeah, let me see. Call...
There's Infinite Warfare.
Call of Duty...
Isn't it called Infinite Warfare?
It might be Infinite Warfare. Call of Duty... Is it coming out this year or next year?
I don't know. I haven't played Call of Duty since Black Ops 2, and I only played that one for zombies.
Yeah, Infinite Warfare. It comes out real soon.
Oh.
The only reason why people are saying that they're going to buy this is because it comes with a remastered version of the first...
Or Call of Duty 4.
Yeah.
Yeah, I that's why I'd buy it. Yeah. Call of Duty 4 is the best Call of Duty.
And of course, I find it hilarious that... So normally Call of Duty beats out Battlefield.
Yeah.
That's just how it is. And Xbox had that exclusive. All exciting. Now that PlayStation has the exclusive on... They got the exclusive on Call of Duty the year that Call of Duty's probably going to lose.
What do you mean? Wait, what? What's
okay.
The exclusive.
Like PlayStation users get like the DLC first.
Oh, okay,
It's not really actual exclusives. They just get access to shit first.
Okay.
But Battlefield 1 actually looks good. So I think.
Last man standing. When very low on health, killing an enemy gives health.
Eh. No.
That's my Firebird, so no.
No. I like your assless chaps better.
Assless chaps.
Actually, Battlefield 1 comes out near the end of this month. Comes out on the 21st. Crazy. But we'll not be buying it because I'm already have a game coming out this month and next month. So
what games do you have coming out?
I get the WWE 2K17 stuff on Tuesday. The brand new Pokemon games are coming out next month.
Ah, right.
Sun and Moon! Super excited! I am legit taking a couple days off work.
Are you actually?
Well, I have loo time anyways.
Oh, okay.
So I'm going to take a couple loo days to record and put out a bunch of Pokemon. That's right, you heard it here. I will be playing Pokemon Sun and Moon myself for the channel. So tell your friends.
Yeah, it's based on how much you play Pokemon. I don't think that's something I could sit through.
Well, you might be, just
well,
because...
Well, if it was like a Nuzlocke challenge, then probably.
I was thinking of maybe doing that, because I imagine most people are going to be doing the standard, like, hey, it's a brand new game, let's talk and do absolutely everything.
I like both these, actually.
Those are pretty good. What's the Undertow boost do?
It just increases the effect range.
Oh, okay. So you can use it farther.
I actually kind of forgot that I had this too, so now I can use this with less, costs less, and the ammo that I grab can be sucked up into my guns.
Sweet. But,
yeah,
you might be able to see, just because it is, like, brand spanking new.
What is?
The new games that are coming out.
Oh.
Like, it's 7th generation. And actually, they've completely changed how the games are. Like, completely. It's really weird. Because you know how standard Pokemon practice is? Get your Pokemon, go fight the 8 gyms, then go do the Elite Four, then you're done.
Pretty much, yeah.
There's no gyms in this game.
Kitted out. What, really?
Yeah, there's 0 gyms.
Huh.
It's based on Hawaii, and you do, like, island challenges instead.
Interesting.
Yeah. So, yeah, there's no gyms. There's no Elite Four.
Huh. Oh, yeah, and since you're buying 2 copies each, so you're going to have 4 copies of the same game, pretty much.
Yep.
You could easily just do one on your own, like, solo stuff, and then one just on, like, a Nuzlocke during the channel.
I could.
And it wouldn't even have to overwrite your save file.
Nope.
Because you're crazy. You and Steph are crazy.
I just love Pokemon. Pokemon's easily my favorite game series.
Oh, that's like a fucking understatement.
That, yeah. Considering I started a new Wonderlock on Pokemon Y, and I think it's like my... I think I've done 4 Nuzlockes, 5 regular playthroughs, and I think I'm on my 6th Wonderlock for that game.
Wow. Yeah. So I've done 1 Nuzlocke for Pokemon Y, and I did 1 for Omega Ruby,
and
I got bored of it. I got bored of it. It was so easy.
Ruby is way too easy of a game, like the Omega Ruby. The old Ruby was a little bit harder.
Yeah, like...
Emerald was really hard.
Pokemon Y was probably the best game I played since Emerald.
Yeah. Yeah, I love X and Y.
I only played Y, but I figured they're pretty much the same.
They're pretty much the same. The only thing that's different is, like, the legendaries and a few, like, Pokemon you can encounter.
Which, whatever, Wonder Trade.
Yeah, exactly.
I can't go back to old Pokemons now that they have Wonder Trade. Wonder Trade is, like, the best thing ever.
Yeah, pretty sure they're going to have that in the new one. At least they better.
It's basically gambling. And
it is gambling.
It's like gambling with who gives a fuck if you lost out.
Yeah.
I'm trading out, like, shit Pokemon
and
expecting good.
You're expecting good stuff.
Yeah, if I get, like, a level 1 Charmander, I'm stoked. Like, I know if someone's hatched it from an egg and they're trying to get a shiny or whatever.
Yeah.
But guess what? I now have a Charmander and I'm stoked.
Yeah, or you're like... I love when the people get super pissed that, like, can't believe that I got sent a Caterpie, and then they had sent out, like, a Weedle.
Yeah, basically, I was like, whatever, I'm sending it out again. Who cares?
Yeah. Exactly, you just send it out and you look for something else. Like in the Wonderlock that I'm currently doing, so, you know, you go by Nuzlocke rules, you catch the first Pokemon, you trade it away, you use whatever.
Yeah.
So I had done that, and I traded it away, and I gave up my encounter because... So the way I do it is if they're too high of a level, I trade them back.
Yeah.
Because I couldn't use them anyways.
Yeah.
So I got a level 100 shiny.
Oh,
so I was
so
like keeping that
bank.
In my box.
Yeah.
I'm like keeping that in the box for when I'm done and transfer it to the bank.
Oh, yeah.
Especially because it was a shiny I've never had before. So.
Which one was it?
Seismitoad.
I don't even know what that is.
I'll show you. It's not a pretty looking shiny by any means, but it's a shiny, so I'm like, yeah.
I remember when you and I were doing the Nuzlockes beside each other, and you got, like, the shiny bunny Pokemon, and you were like, ah!
Well, I remember because, yeah, so I wanted to do a practice Nuzlocke on X before I did for the channel because I just wanted to make sure that I knew everything. So literally, first Pokemon I encounter in the very first route of the game was a shiny.
Shiny Bunnelby, I think it's called?
Yeah.
Yeah, and you were just like, ah!
Oh, shit. And then I've done other, like, it's called a Soul Link, so you need two people to play. And I was doing one with Steph, and I ran in, and my first encounter was a shiny, and she's like, I'm fucking done! Because I keep finding shinies, and she can never find them.
I only got a shiny masquerade.
Masquerade.
It was like a fucking moth or some shit.
Yeah.
I got a shiny one of those. Oh yeah,
it's not a nice looking shiny. There's the non-shiny version of it.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
I like the non-shiny better, in all honesty.
But hey, a shiny's a shiny, so.
True facts.
Plus, Seismitoad's actually a good Pokemon, even though it's ugly as fuck.
I remember this part being difficult.
Yeah. It's okay, so while we're going through this door, though, I think we're actually going to call it here for today. Sorry if it's a bit shorter or a bit long, but I was dumb and I forgot to run a timer. So make sure that you comment any game suggestions and hashtag FigureT in the comment down below. Keep calm and game on.
Goodbye.
Bye.